हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ डॉक्टर शीना बांसल। सो टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द स्कैपुला एंड इट्स अटैचमेंट्स। सी, दिस इज़ स्पाइनस प्रोसेस। दिस इज़ द अपर लिप ऑफ स्पाइनस प्रोसेस एंड दिस इज़ द लोअर लिप ऑफ स्पाइनस प्रोसेस। ऑन अपर लिप ट्रेपीजियस गेट अटैच्ड एंड ऑन लोअर लिप डेल्टॉइड गेट अटैच्ड। सी, योर अपर लिप ऑफ स्पाइनस प्रोसेस कंटिन्यूज विद द मीडियल बॉर्डर ऑफ your acromion process and lower lip of spinous process continues with the lateral border of acromion process. So we can say that your trapezius attached on upper lip of spinous process and medial border of acromion process and deltoid muscle attached on lower lip of spinous process and lateral border of acromion process. See, this is your coracoid process. Here three muscles get attached, that is pectoralis minor, coracobrachialis and short head of bicep brachii. Coracobrachialis name is indicating itself. So three muscles get attached on coracoid process, as I have written here, you can see. Now see your medial border here. See your medial border here on the costal medial, on the costal surface of medial border, your serratus anterior get attached, as I have written here. See, on medial border, your serratus anterior get attached on the costal surface side, and on the posterior side of your this medial border, three muscles get attached, that is levator scapula, rhomboidus minor and rhomboidus major. Levator scapula from superior angle to the root of spine, rhomboidus minus opposite to root of spine, and rhomboidus major from root of spine to the inferior angle. You can see three muscles, levator scapula, rhomboidus minor and rhomboidus major. Now see your glenoid cavity. Here is supraglenoid tubercle and here is infraglenoid tubercle. Supraglenoid and infraglenoid. See, supraglenoid tubercle and infraglenoid tubercle. On the supraglenoid tubercle, long head of bicep brachii get attached, and on the infraglenoid tubercle, your long head of triceps get attached. You can see here, this is supraglenoid, this is infraglenoid. Now see the lateral border. This is your lateral border. On upper two-third, teres minor get attached, and on the lower one-third, teres major get attached. Teres minor get attached with the two strips, and in between the two strips, circumflex scapular artery passes. Are you seeing here? See, as I have written here, teres minor and teres major. Now see suprascapular notch. Here inferior belly of omohyoid muscle get attached just near to suprascapular notch. Now see at the inferior angle, here latissimus dorsi muscle gets attached, and you can see here. See the coracobrachialis muscle, it flexes and adducts the arm. You can see the muscle fibers. Now see pectoralis minor, it stabilizes scapula by drawing it inferiorly and anteriorly against thoracic wall. Now see bicep brachii, it supinates forearm, and when it is supine, it flexes forearm. See serratus anterior, it draws scapula forward and upward, abducts scapula and rotates it, stabilizes vertebral border of scapula. levator scapula elevates scapula and tilts its glenoid cavity inferiorly by rotating scapula. Rhomboides minor and major retract scapula and rotate it to depress glenoid cavity, fix scapula to thoracic wall. Triceps chief extensor of forearm, long head steadies head of abducted humerus. Teres minor laterally rotates arm, helps to hold humeral head in glenoid cavity of scapula. Teres major adduct and medially rotate the arm. Now see latissimus dorsi, it extends, adducts and medially rotates humerus and raises body towards arm during climbing. Thank you so much. With this, I end my today's session.